I'm going to share a technique in this video that is so powerful. I'm a little scared to give it out, having a lot of trouble to actually sit down and do this video. I used it today and it was so powerful. That I got almost the jitters. Very simple, very simple. The form will be so we say, time, use a subject, time, inclusiveness, life, freedom, spirit, oneness, is totally now. Freedom is totally now. Life is totally now. Life is totally now. Truth is totally now. Oneness is totally now. Thought is totally now. Space is totally now. Clarity is totally now. Peace is totally now. Everything is totally now. This plant as it is totally now. This world as it is totally now. This world is totally now. This universe is totally now. This place is totally now. This day is totally now. So then we can do some variations. This day is totally this day. Oneness is totally oneness. Peace is totally peace. Life is totally life. This world is totally this world. This universe is totally this universe. This universe is totally this universe now. This universe is totally this universe now. This planet is totally this planet now. This day is totally this day now. This day is totally now. All right. Now we're going to add one more. All oneness is totally now. All space is totally now. All of this world is totally now. All of time is totally now. All of now is totally now. All of this plant is totally now. All of love is totally now. And then we can say, All of love is totally love now. All of peace is totally peace now. The cat enjoys these meditations. Every time I start, the cat has to come here and sit. So I can calm down the cat. Okay, not really. All of this world is totally now. All of my life is totally now. All of life is totally now. All of life is totally life right now. All of life is totally life right now. All of wellness is totally wellness right now. This cat, all of this cat is totally this cat right now. All of the spaciousness is totally this spaciousness right now. All of the spaciousness is totally now. This spaciousness is totally now. This scenery, all of the scenery is totally now. All of the scenery is totally now. All of the scenery is totally this scenery. All of these thoughts are totally these thoughts. All happiness is totally now. All process is totally now. All being is totally now. All oneness is totally oneness. Oneness is totally oneness. Oneness is totally now. Now is totally now. And this technique hit so hard today. It was like painful. I was like gasping for breath. It's like, can't take it anymore. Now is totally now. Now is totally now. This is totally this. This is totally this. All of this is totally all of this. All of now is totally all of now. All of this world is totally all of this world. This world is totally now. This world is totally this world. All of this world is totally this world. This world is totally now. This plant is totally now. This desk is totally now. This light is totally now. This bench is totally now. This air is totally now. This air is totally now. All air is totally now. All plants are totally now. All sky is totally now. All sky is totally now. All planets are totally now. All universes are totally now. All concepts are totally now. All concepts are totally all concepts. So I'm sort of blocking the reaction because the reaction was so strong today that I might not be able to even talk. I want to get this practice out to you. Because if you really let it sink in and you hear what it's saying, it's just stunning. All peace is totally now. Everything is totally now. Everything is totally now. And you see, that's the one that hits hard. Everything is totally now. And with that, the cat finally settled down. Wouldn't settle down until I said that one. Maybe that knocked the cat out right there. He said, I need to sit down after that one. Everything is totally now. Everything is totally now. Eternal life is totally now. Vastness, all vastness is totally now. All vastness is totally now. And so this completely challenges our belief system, doesn't it? It's like it upends the apple cart. Now, we need this intense practice. The world is simply made of projection. It's made of projection. Projection makes projection, and it fragments and fragments and fragments and fragments and fragments. It really turns into a black hole. This world is really a black hole, a spiritual black hole. And if we are just standing still, not progressing, we're actually sinking. We're actually sinking. If we just think status quo, stay in the middle ground of status quo in this world, we're sinking into a spiritual black hole rapidly. In order to avoid this sinking into a black hole, we need to vigorously and intensely pursue freedom from these projections. So intense, right, spiritual practice is totally necessary to avoid sinking into this black hole, where projections, beget more projections, it just spreads out more and more and more into darker and darker and darker and darker, terrible spiritual black hole. So we have to vigorously pursue our liberation from this. And therefore we need these intense spiritual practice, That which really, really, really has traction. Everything is totally everything. Everything is totally everything. Everything is totally everything. Everything is totally now. Everything is totally now. What does that do to your projections, right? What does that do to our projections? Evaporates them, doesn't it? It's like putting an ice cube in a microwave. I haven't really tried that, but I'm sure the ice cube would melt. Everything is totally now. Now is totally now. Freedom is totally now. All freedom is totally now. All freedom is totally now. Everything is totally now. All truth is totally now. All truth is totally true. Now. Right now. All truth is totally true right now. All truth is totally true right now. Right now is totally right now. Right now is totally right now. And what I find is happening is the ego is now whistling in the dark. The ego thinks like it's going past some graveyard or something. It's whistling in the dark. It keeps saying this phrase in my mind over and over and over, constantly, more and more and more. It's just like it's panicked. It's scared out of its wits. Because this is the end of projection. The ego is a projection. All projections are totally now. All projections are totally now. Projections are totally now. All projections are totally projections right now. The ego is right now. The ego is totally right now. The ego is totally the ego right now. The ego is totally the ego right now. Space is totally space right now. Space is totally now. All 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 spaciousness is totally now. All spaciousness is totally all spaciousness. Right now. We can think about that. All spaciousness is right now. Where else could it be? Where else could spaciousness be? Where else could spaciousness be except right now? Isn't all spaciousness right now? Can't the total abstraction of complete emptiness, cannot that be right now? Right now? Does that need to be added on to? Does the idea of total absence, pure spaciousness, absence of any content or quality or characteristics, can't that idea be right now and not need to be added on to in any particular way? I mean, it's all present right now. Isn't that the case? And we can say all plants are totally now. All plants are totally now. All non-plants, all absence of plants is totally now. All absence of plants is totally now. Right? All plants are totally now. All absence of plants are totally now. The manifest is totally now, right? What is manifest is totally now. All that is manifest is totally now, right? All that is unmanifest is totally now, too. All that is unmanifest is totally now. All spaciousness is totally now. And within all spaciousness that is totally now, you have all appearances which are totally now, and all non-appearances which are totally now, all in the pure spaciousness which is totally now. If you want to get sophisticated about it, but it's not really necessary. Everything is totally now. Each moment, everything is now. Everything is now. Everything is now. We get fooled by location and perception. We get fooled by location, perceptual location, right? Because what we're perceiving here, and that's over there, and we automatically assume that what's over there is not quite now. Not quite now. We can see that right here is kind of now, but the further out we go from where we're at, it doesn't seem like now anymore. So if we think about something taking place around the world, we can say, it doesn't seem like it's happening, totally happening, all happening right now. Because I can see the stuff around me, and it's not happening there. So location is the problem. Perception implies a point of perception, right? Something that is perceiving. So that's a location. Perception implies a location. And from that location, what happens is we feel that the center of perception is more now than the periphery. If we think of like a billion light years away from here, can we say that is totally now? All space is totally now? You see how this is a very different, it's freeing us from our perceptual belief system, a belief system based on perception, which is actually projection. Because in projection we say something inside of me isn't where it is, it's out there. It's distant, so there's a lack of sense of immediacy. There's a separation, so it doesn't feel like it's totally now. It doesn't feel like it's totally now. So projection makes perception, makes belief in time space, and makes delusional belief system that everything is not totally now. That there is time. Time-space in this regard. Relativism of location comes in. All of that. This is what we're practicing to get free of. All of this is totally now. All of that is totally now. All of that is totally now. All of this is totally now. All of that is totally now. All of this world is totally now. All of this world is totally now. All of this universe is totally now. All of the many universes is totally now. Everything is totally now. Everything is totally everything. Everything is totally everything right now. Everything is totally everything now. This is all true statements, but our belief system doesn't believe it. That is the problem. That is the delusion. That is the sleep. That is why we don't see God. We don't believe in God. We believe in a relativism, dualism, a relativistic God. God, a locational God, actually, arises from this belief system, from projection. The original projection was a projection of our desire to displace God from being prime creator, from reality, to displace God and put ourselves in the place of God as prime creator. And we felt we were losing all of reality. It was like vanishing, like it was going to vanish, feeling like, oh, it's gone, where'd it go? And then we projected that onto God and said, God is trying to dispossess us of reality because God feels threatened by us wanting to take over place of prime creator. So God's the one that feels threatened and is attacking us. It was a projection. From that projection, that begat more projection, more, until we're here with this perceptual situation where perception is here and objects are out there. And so I am the center of time space, and out there it's sort of a gradation. Anything that's like nearer to us we feel is more now than stuff that is farther away from us. If you look at a distant mountain, do you feel it's equally now as your hand? If you're looking right at your hand, say, wow, this hand is right here now. That mountain, that's over there. It's over there. It's distant. And it feels different to us. It feels different. Now, in the some of the instances I've had of the dawning of the vision of oneness, the vision of oneness is a different belief system, not based on our perception that we have, based on the Holy Spirit's perception. The Holy Spirit's perception sees everything equally as now. And this is the vision of oneness. And when you experience this, you have a different feeling. You have a feeling of like this tremendous richness, just this super richness, because you feel as if you're near to everything, or everything is equally, you know, here for you. It's equally here. There's no such thing as distant. You don't feel any sense of distance in terms of how you feel. For instance, like you're looking at a mountain far away, and it was as if that mountain was totally near and dear to you, completely near to you, as is everything. Everything. You see? That's the vision of oneness. So what we are practicing is directly leading us to that vision of oneness. It's the Holy Spirit's perception. It sees the entire universe as totally now. Totally now. So you see, it's not as mysterious as you might think, not at all. And we have just laid it bare for what it is actually, the whole situation. That's why we say the vision of oneness is this feeling of near and dearness. Everything is very precious to us, very precious. What do we think of as precious? Something like a diamond ring on our finger, right? See, this diamond ring is near and dear. It's always on my finger. It's always near to me, to the center of my perception. And so it's near and dear to me. It's precious, very precious. And the stuff way over there, you know, halfway around the world, is that near and dear and precious? No. But vision of oneness, everything feels precious to us. Everything is incredibly precious to us, without exception. And this gives a feeling that we haven't felt before. That's what I felt. I felt something I've never felt before. It's just wow. I said, wow. It's just this richness, this incredible richness of dearness, you know, preciousness. Just this total preciousness, sacredness. Some people, they call it sacredness or blessedness. Those are some of the terms that I guess have been used to describe this. This total blessedness. Everything is blessed. Everything is blessed. And we literally can experience that. And these exercises could bring us right into it. Right into it. So you might say the Holy Spirit's perception, the center of His perception is everywhere. So we can say the center of my perception is everywhere. This plant is totally centered in eternal life. This plant is totally centered in eternal life. That mountain is totally centered in eternal life. That mountain is totally centered in optimal oneness. That sun is totally centered in optimal oneness. This air is totally centered in optimal oneness. That sky is totally centered in optimal oneness. That star is totally centered in the one vastness, in the oneness. That star is totally centered in the oneness. That star This planet is totally centered in the oneness, in the vast oneness. This planet is totally centered in the vast oneness. I am totally centered in the vast oneness. This tree is totally centered in the vast oneness. So you see what we're practicing here? We're literally adjusting our belief system and adjusting our expectations so that when the vision of oneness comes, we'll say, oh yeah, I expected this. Come on in, we were expecting you. Maybe we'll start singing the theme from The Love Boat. Come aboard, we're expecting you. So come on aboard. We're expecting this. We're expecting that star, that distant star, is totally and optimally centered in the vast oneness of eternal life. This pebble here is totally and optimally centered in the vast oneness that is eternal life. Right now, as it is right now, this pebble as it is optimally centered. This tree as it is optimally centered. This water is as it is optimally centered. That mountain as it is optimally centered. That bird as it is optimally centered. This sky as it is optimally centered. This world spaciousness as it is optimally centered in the one eternal life that is now. Everything is totally now. Everything is totally now. Everything is totally now. Okay, that says it all right there. That's why it's such a powerful one. This is like a knockout blow. Everything is totally now. So our perception doesn't see that. Our belief system, based on our projection and perception and belief system, those three, doesn't see it that way at all. It doesn't think that everything is totally now. It thinks that right here is totally now, but over there, it's not totally now yet. Not yet. Or it was, is no longer totally now. It's no longer. Here is totally now. There, we think it's the past. It's no longer totally now. Or if you think it's the future, it's not yet totally now. But what we're saying is everything is totally now. Everything is totally now. Everything is totally now. Now, now, everything is equally totally now. Everything is totally everything right now. So this is just a completely direct way. We're directly working on the root of our delusion. And we're removing the blocks to the vision of oneness, which resolves the continuity problem for us, which is the only problem we really have. Just like in a dream, when we're all suffering so terrible in a dream, what's the real problem? We're not waking up from the dream. How do we wake up from the dream is the only question. How do we wake up from this dream? Because when we wake up, all gone, all gone. All equally gone. So the delusion of location is all equally gone when we see the vision of oneness. Just in one shift, which I experienced just very faintly, the dawning of this. One shift into the vision of oneness, and all problems gone. All locational, the whole complex, the whole projection, perception, belief, locational complex, gone just like that. Everything is equally, totally here now. Everything is totally here now. Everything is totally here now. Everything is totally here now. That mountain is totally here now. This seat is totally here now. That sun is totally here now. That star is totally here now. This stone is totally here now. This air is totally here now. That sky is totally here now. Everything is totally here right now. Everything is here. Everything is totally here right now. That is what you see. You experience it. You experience it. And it's amazing. And there are really no words necessary. Except everything is totally here now. And you say, wow, what? Wow. My gosh. And this is like a revelation. It's dawning of this, you know, realization of God. Everything is totally here now. It's different than what we've been perceiving. And the different feeling comes along with it. Different feeling comes along with it for sure. It's like a miracle, really. And so we're not far off from that at all. These practices bring us right there, right there, right there. And what's shocking is how easy it is. And what's also shocking is how simple and clear that this explanation is. I'm being shocked by it. I said, oh my gosh, it's not all mysterious and hidden. I can't really hide from it anymore. I see it. I see for what it is. How can we hide anymore? My gosh, it's obvious. It's very clear. Is that projection makes perception, makes the belief in location, and makes a belief in time, space, and all of this. Subtly, we feel an otherness. We feel an otherness. We feel an alienation. We feel a loneliness. Don't we? We feel a loneliness. We feel a depression. We feel a lack. We feel an emptiness. We feel something's wrong with us. Vision of oneness cures all of that instantly. Cured. Cured. Without a trace left. Without a trace left. It's like someone who doesn't have even a penny. And suddenly they have a mountain of gold. Well, their poverty is cured that very instant. They're not poor anymore. And we have this incredible poverty based on projection, perception, and belief of time, space, that we're in relativism, dualism. We have this unbelievable spiritual poverty. And the vision of oneness dawns on us, and that is gone. Gone. Vanishes. And all it has to do is we're now seeing through the eyes of the Holy Spirit, the perception of the Holy Spirit, the belief system of the Holy Spirit, and its center is everywhere. Its perceptual center is everywhere. It's everywhereness. And so everything seems completely precious and dear to us, like it's our totally best friend forever. Everything is like our totally best friend forever. And that's a big change from feeling the sense of friendlessness, right? And if you're like me, you've had this set feeling of friendlessness, you know, like, because nothing feels right. No matter what friend you have, it never feels quite right, does it? They're never enough. And so you just say, wow, friends are not the answer. But you feel friendless in this world. We really feel alienated in this world. But now we know why. Now we know why. And I can see now why I was afraid to do this video. It's too intense. I said, well, I don't know if I can do it. I really don't know if I can do this. Phew, boy. I spent a lot of hours fooling around with fancy graphics and thinking about stop motion, special effects, there's all this, you know, incredible, clever stuff I can do on the computer. And I just said, no, I just gotta go out here and just deliver it, just pure and simple like this. But I was really, almost didn't do it. Boy, wow, this is just over the top intense. I don't even know what to say. It's just like completely spilled the beans on the entire thing, you know? Can't put the cat back in the bag. super nervous all day, jumpy, intense though, very intense. I said, there's something I gotta get out. It's just urgent, you know, really, really. Let's do this vigorous video, gotta do it. And it's like, whoa, maybe it's gonna be too intense. Well, I mean, I feel fine, feel relaxed and calm. But it's also, there's like this, you know, like, wow. Did I just hear what I just heard? Did I just hear that? Does that really say all that? I mean, does that really come out here? I mean, is this for real, or is this a Twilight Zone or something? I mean, yeah, it really happened. Wow. So I'm almost kind of like in a state of shock a little bit. Because this just like evaporates the barrier between, you know, where we're at in a vision of oneness. It just evaporates the barrier. It just completely normalizes it. It just makes it plain as day. Mystery's gone. Phew. Never even thought of this. In my whole life, I never even thought of this. You know, never saw it. Never saw it. But now you hear it and you say, of course. No wonder why we feel alienated. No wonder why we feel ill at ease in the world, because we think that there's an abyss out there of the past or the future, and that we're here, but everything out there is we're sort of constantly worried about an abyss because it's not really now. It's already gone or hasn't yet got here. And so we're moving in this anxiety and trepidation, and we cling to things and persons. We want to get more and more things, right? We stuff our room full of things. We want to have all this stuff close to us. We want to be close. We cluster together in cities. We want to be close, because out there it's not really now. We don't think it's not now. So what is it? It's scary. It's death. It's death, right? It's evaporation. It's that which is not now. And we've been living with this. We're living in a nightmare. We're living in this terrible, terrible, terrible nightmare. And now we know what the remedy is. We're given a perception whose center is everywhere, whose perceptual center is everywhere. Perceptual center is everywhere. Therefore, there is no such thing as distance. There is no meaning to location in terms of nowness, of totally here nowness. Location is totally irrelevant. Totally irrelevant. And you can think about a mountain or think about a star, and you get this sense of it. That thought is here now, totally here now. The star is totally here now. Everything you think about is totally here now. Your thoughts are totally here now. There's no sense when you're thinking of being alienated, nothing like that. So the total complex of your psyche becomes totally stable, which is what's called bliss. Which is what's called stillness, which is what's called peace. Peace beyond understanding, peace beyond location, peace beyond time-space, peace beyond perception, peace beyond belief, peace beyond understanding. That is what you experience. And it's right here for us right now. And it's totally explainable, isn't it? Totally explainable. Because we know, even though intellectually we can argue it forever, that what is distant from us, our perception, we don't feel as close and near and dear to it. We don't. There's no question about this dynamic that we have of that causes stratification, a feeling of separation, of distance and alienation, stratification, levels, everything, all of that, dimensions, all these levels totally come from projection, perception, belief. And all of that in one shift to the Holy Spirit's perception is no longer the slightest problem for us, gone forever. Pretty cool. Very, very nice. Very nice. So when I experienced the dawning of this vision of oneness, it was just wonderful. But I didn't quite understand it. I didn't quite understand it. Not like now. Not like now. That was like a week and a half ago. So it's only taken a week and a half to get to this point, actually. Where now I can understand it. Say, wow, sure, okay. Sometimes they depict enlightenment of someone with like a thousand eyes, you know, some kind of crown with a thousand eyes, or the head, the Buddha has all these little areas on the head look like a thousand eyes or something. It's depicting the vision of the Holy Spirit, perception of the Holy Spirit, which is center is everywhere. The center is everywhere. And therefore there is no perceptual distance at all. No alienation, no separation, no distinct, no levels. Everything is totally smoothed out sameness in terms of being here, totally now. Everything is totally now. Everything is totally now. So this is great. This is really great. What's the date? I don't know. It's the 19th of February. And so we're getting some major traction right here. Which is exactly what we need. Exactly, I've said we've got to get it in this short time frame. We've got to get it. It has to be grounded here in some way. It can't be a mystery. But by the time we hit March of 2014, it cannot be a mystery to us. We cannot be confused. At least we have some familiarity and say, you know what? I don't think it's that much of a mystery. I don't think it's a mystery. I think I can get it. That is going to be your protection from what is to come here in this world, for sure. You can say, oh, it's very understandable, it's easily understandable. I accept it. I have this continuity problem, severe continuity problem. Of I've been in this severe delusion for so long that I'm afraid to just completely let go, just to know that everything is totally here now, just to know it. So what do I do first? I perceive it. So the Holy Spirit gives us a perception of everything is totally here now, a perception that is not the same as pure knowledge, pure knowing, okay? We don't have to go into pure knowing. The intermediate step is a perception. So we're still perceiving, but the feeling we get is it's all here, totally here now, totally precious, totally sacred, totally blessed, everything is totally blessed. Is everything's the center of the universe. Everything's a center, is centered in eternal life. Everything is centered in God. We're perceiving it. We're not knowing it. We don't need to know it. We're perceiving it. Once we perceive it and get used to perceiving it, then we can even drop the perception of it and we will know it directly. So we definitely can perceive it. This is not some goal way out there, right? You see, that's the problem with our belief system, isn't it? We think that enlightenment is some distant, way over there, very distant. It's not. It's here now. It's all, everything is totally here now. But perception will project it and say it's not here, it's out there. And so people think that it's in the future or in the past, and they cannot quite get it because of this terrible continuity issue we have of feeling distancing and feeling that is what is distant is not present right now. That's the trouble. That's the trouble we have. And it's a big trouble. It's a real big trouble. But once you start to, this starts to unravel on you and you start to get it, the progress is very rapid. Very rapid. But it can feel like you're on a long pilgrimage. You know, you're driving, and you know, it's always in the distance. It's always in the distance. You're on the road to Shambhala, basically. Shambhala is totally here right now. The perception of the Holy Spirit, the vision of the Holy Spirit, is totally here right now. The perception, the vision of the Holy Spirit is totally the vision of the Holy Spirit right now. So eventually you find out Shambhala is totally here right now. Right? Everything is Shambhala right now. Shambhala, everything is totally Shambhala right now. There is no road to Shambhala. Shambhala is totally here right now. Everything. That's what we eventually find out. So as you're driving along this road on the spiritual path, you're studying, getting this feeling like, wow, you know, this road is very weary. I need to really figure this out. I mean, this is just really tough. And it is. It's very tough. I can't even express how difficult it is. It has been. It's like coming out of a coma. You know, it's when you're in a coma, you're just so confused. And even, you know, it's just difficult. But hopefully this explanation, these exercises, are triggering something and you're saying, you know what, it is not nearly as difficult as I thought. You know, that's the best boost you can get, is to feel that way. You just feel it and say, wow, I think it's a lot easier than I've been thinking and believing. A lot easier. It's my projection, perception, belief that has been tricking me all this time. And then the fear of the continuity issue, I don't want to drop it all right away. So I keep being loyal to this dynamic of projection, perception, and belief, which gives me this sense of alienation, separation, uneasiness. The abyss is out there. You know, it's just everything at a distance kind of seems foreign and strange and all this kind of stuff. And I try to travel around the world trying to get rid of it, but I just never seem to really get rid of it. As I said, my dad was a great, great world traveler, actually, and just went about everywhere on this planet. And at the end of his life, he came back and I said, you know, what did you find? Did you find it looking for? He said, no, it's not out there. Forget it. He says, don't waste your time. And so I didn't waste my time. I just stayed right in one place my whole life, actually. I've been right here in the same place my entire life. I haven't gone anywhere. Because I know is a waste of time. Listen to those who've done it. You know, listen from the failures of others. Most definitely. That's the way you can honor them, really. If you want to honor your ancestors, etc., learn from their failures. They didn't find it, right? Why didn't they find it? Did they tell you? You know, yeah, I've gotten a lot of help from a lot of people, actually, because I listened to what they said. And they said, you're not going to find it this way. I tried, and believe me, it's not, that's, you won't find it. And I believe them. I believe it. The entire universe is Shambhala. It's everywhere. Everywhereness is Shambhala. Shambhala is here now. Vision of oneness is here now. Everything is totally now. Now is totally now. Everything is totally now. So, we don't have to go around the world and go chasing after it. We don't have to chase after it. That's not the way. That's why sitting, just sitting quietly, you're not chasing after anything. Don't chase after anything. That's extremely helpful. Don't feel like you have to go anywhere or do anything or chase after anything or get anything. I have a vast continuity problem, no question. I have a severe continuity problem. That's the only problem I have. It's the only problem I have. Vision of oneness solves this problem perfectly. Vision of oneness, what is it? It's the perception of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit shares its perception with us. Perception of the Holy Spirit, its center, the center of that perception is everywhere. And thus there is no distancing locational issue at all. Everything feels totally now. Totally now. No matter where it is, it makes no difference if something's on the other side of the universe or the galaxy or the planet. It's equally, feels equally now and present to you as your hands. And you might say, well, I won't have my same identity. Well, identity is based on the feeling that what's out there is not here now, that only we are, and the stuff closer then recedes. And this is the sense of identity we have, which is a very unstable, terrible sense of identity. So why wouldn't we be happy to part ways with that? It's a lousy, lousy, terrible identity, a terrible struggle, right? Always feeling like the world is going to swallow you up. The past or the future is going to devour you. The lack of nowness always seems to be chasing after you. And then you project more and more to protect and all this, and you get more and more trapped. So, well, we did it, we did it, we did it. We got, yeah, very great. We could go on and on, but this is probably enough. It's a real stunner. It's a real stunner to realize that we're not trapped. We're not trapped. That the advice we've gotten is legitimate. It's reasonable, it's legitimate. See, those who have accepted the vision of oneness already, they gave us the right testimony. Everything fits. We're not trapped. We're not trapped at all. We're not trapped. We have the answer. Easily. So, we're not going to be enslaved forever, for sure. Most definitely we're going to get free of this wretched, non-identity. And I think the cats are fighting over there. Something's going on. I'm going to have to see what's going on. Okay. Very great. That's it.